Hey everyone. Well, it finally happened, something I've been waiting for months now. Trevor Milton, the ex-founder, well, I guess he's still the founder, he just doesn't work there anymore. Anyway, the founder of Nikola has been subpoenaed. They were grand jury subpoenas issued by the DOJ, and not only that, but Nikola Motors, the company, has also been subpoenaed, along with the entire board of directors and 8 employees and officers.
5 officers received subpoenas from the SEC, 3 more got them on September 21st. Can you share with us what the SEC is exactly looking for here?
Well, you know, no company would comment on ongoing SEC matters, so we're cooperating with them and doing everything we can to help them in their work. Mm-hmm. But we don't comment on an ongoing SEC matter.
The subpoenas were for a fact-finding inquiry related to the aspects of the company's business and also to look into the allegations that were brought up by the Hindenburg Research Report. The subpoenas were issued on September 19th, but Nikola just disclosed them in a regulatory filing late on Monday the 9th. Then the interviewer says this.
Should investors be concerned about these subpoenas?
We're very focused on our milestones going forward. You know, at the break, before we came in, we were talking about the trucks that we have being completed in Ulm, Germany, the first one of which has gone on the track and it's been on the dyno. It's very exciting. We think that's going to be a groundbreaking truck that the world is going to love, and it's going to help us go to zero emissions.
And to answer his question, yes, of course investors should be worried that there's an ongoing investigation into the company they're invested in. That is a gimme. But notice how Mark Russell pivots from the question and goes to what they are currently accomplishing. It's really a basic politician move, which is to not answer the question, just talk about what you want to talk about. And in this case, something positive the company is doing. But also, to be totally fair, what did you think Mark Russell was gonna say? Yes, investors should be terrified. This is really bad. I go home and cry every night just thinking about it. Nah, so I guess good job to Mark, but it does make me miss Trevor Milton because his answers were always more fun.
Take us through that. It is up and running. I know there was some concerns coming off the Hindenburg report on what you actually have in terms of trucks that move. So you're saying this runs, and when might that be available to customers?
So we have a number of trucks that run. We have a couple of hydrogen fuel cell prototypes that have been running for more than a year.
Did you catch that? We have a couple of hydrogen fuel cell prototypes that have been running for more than a year. To me, a couple means 2, and I think that's what most people would say. And we actually know of the 2 hydrogen fuel cell vehicles that Nikola's talking about. There's a white and black one named Stormtrooper, and there's a red one that they did the delivery to Anheuser-Busch with. But what about the totally functional Nikola One that was announced back in 2016 that was a hydrogen fuel cell prototype? And I guess technically more than a year could mean that they've had them for any amount of time that's over 1 year. But when I hear that, I immediately think that they haven't had the operational fuel cell trucks for much longer than a year. Remember when they unveiled the Nikola One semi to the world in 2016 and Trevor Milton insisted that it wasn't a pusher and that it could drive off the stage and all that? Well, that was around 4 years ago, and according to Trevor, it was fully operational then. So it's weird to me that Russell would say they've had a couple of working fuel cell prototypes for more than a year when we have video proof of 2 Nikola 2 prototypes driving. Maybe I'm looking into it too much, but it looks to me like he just admitted that they didn't have a working prototype of the Nikola 1. Anyway, speaking of the Nikola 1, Nikola did just do an entire redesign of their website, and at first glance, it looks like they removed everything except for the Nikola tray and 2. But if you scroll all the way to the bottom, you can see everything is still there, except for the Nikola 1. I clicked around their site and I couldn't find it anywhere, but check this out. When you Google Nikola 1 and then click on the link, it takes you to the Nikola 2. This basically confirms that they're no longer going to be producing the Nikola 1. I didn't find any mention of it in the Q3 results or anywhere on their site. So they are trying to do this as quietly as possible. What's weird is when I reached out to Nikola just around a month ago, they said they were targeting 2023 for the delivery to customers for the Nikola 1, so I'm kind of surprised that it's just disappearing. Also, they've been taking pre-orders for the Nikola 1 since 2016. So what happens to all those pre-orders if you just discontinue the product? It's not entirely conclusive, but I think we can say that the Nikola 1 is no longer in motion. Turns out there just wasn't a hill big enough to get that thing going. All right, sorry, I had to. I'm still salty about the copyright strikes for that. But another thing about the website redesign is regarding the Nikola Badger. So just in case you weren't aware, the Nikola Badger was their electric and hydrogen pickup truck that they were trying to partner with GM to build. Their partnership with GM has been delayed, and as of right now, we don't know if the partnership will go through. And we have Mark Russell saying that if they don't get a partner to build the Badger, they won't build the Badger.
The Badger was something we were doing because a lot of people were interested in it. And we said from the beginning that if we build the Badger, it will be with a partner. If we don't have a partner, we probably won't build a Badger.
So, okay, let's start trying to piece this puzzle together. The public now knows that Nikola is under investigation by the SEC and DOJ, and that a bunch of their staff, including the entire board and the company itself, has been subpoenaed. Nikola is also facing multiple class action lawsuits over allegedly making misleading and/or false statements. So if Nikola wasn't in a good public light before, they look even worse now. And then we have GM, who's trying to make the decision as to whether or not they want to partner with the company that's currently under investigation and a class action lawsuit. And look, say what you want about GM, but you have to be pretty bold to partner with a company that is in this kind of hot water. Now, GM does have a lot to gain by partnering with Nikola. It's a great deal for them, really. But when you look at what partnering with a company like Nikola will do to their reputation, they really have to think about it. Then they postponed Nikola World, where they were going to show off the Badger to the public, because remember, nobody outside Nikola has actually seen the Badger. Also, they still haven't announced when Nikola World is going to happen, but delaying it bought them more time. Then we have Mark Russell saying that they won't build the Badger if they don't get a partner to do it. And so what does Nikola do? They do an entire website redesign, which takes the Badger from front and center and hides it in the corner. When I look at all those things together in context, to me, it looks like Nikola is preparing to announce that the GM deal has not worked out and they will not be producing the Badger at all. Now, I could be totally wrong here. Don't take my word for it. I'm just making an educated guess. Maybe GM does partner with Nikola to build the Badger, but if that's the case, why would they hide the Badger on their site? If they're about to partner with a giant company, one of the largest automotive manufacturers in the world, who has more than enough manufacturing ability to actually produce the Badger, wouldn't Nikola want to promote it as much as possible to increase their sales? Later in the interview, Russell gets asked about the battery cells, and listen to what he has to say.
What about the battery technology, Mark? There are also some concerns raised on the report on what IP in terms of battery technology Nikola does in fact have. What do you own and what don't you own?
Well, we use the same basic cells as pretty much everybody does. There's only four or five major producers of battery cells, particularly cylindrical cells, in the world. And pretty much every battery in a vehicle uses one of those. And even if you're using a different format, it's often from those same suppliers. There's really a small concentration of global suppliers of battery cells. Those are put into battery packs, or usually into a module that's then assembled into a pack. So what most people own if they're doing batteries for a vehicle is the pack. And that's what Nikola has. We've designed our pack. It's proprietary to us, but it uses a module from a company called Romeo. And when we use cylindrical cells in those modules that come from suppliers in Korea.
And look, to some people who don't know the history, that might sound like a reasonable answer. But I'm sure, as most of you know, Nikola made some outrageous battery claims about a year ago. And when I listened to the interviewer's questions, that's what I think he was asking about. And if you go to Nikola's site, they still have the announcement about their game-changing battery, which they're going to show to the public at Nikola World 2020 and show at Cycling. And yet, Russell doesn't mention a thing about it. He talks about this battery being built by a third-party supplier and how it's basically the same battery as everyone else has, which is totally fine. But when I hear that, and how he doesn't even mention anything at all about the game-changing battery cell, it sounds to me like they don't have it. And look, let's be real here. We know they don't have the battery cell. It was a ridiculous claim to begin with. But I did want to hear someone at Nikola say, yeah, well, about that, we were wrong. And just for fun, let's look at those battery claims. Nikola battery electric trucks could now drive 800 miles fully loaded between charges. Nikola trucks could weigh 5,000 pounds less than the competition if same battery size was kept. So yeah, this is what the interviewer was asking about, and like always, Russell just dodges the question. I never really thought I was going to miss Trevor Milton, but man, he really made things entertaining. Then, towards the end of the interview, Russell gets asked about raising money, which I am so glad he asked. If you've seen any of my other videos, you know I've talked about it a bunch, but if you haven't, the short of it is this. Nikola doesn't have even close to the amount of capital they need to complete their goals. When we look at the cost for the hydrogen stations alone, they're going to cost around $1 billion per year for the next 7 years. And that's using Nikola's own numbers, which is that they're stating that the stations are going to cost around $15 million each, and they want to build around 70 stations per year. Based on my calculations, I think each station is going to cost way more than $15 million. For a deeper dive on that, check out this video here. But even if we use their numbers, that's still $1 billion a year. Now, the way they've gotten around that is by just not building hydrogen refueling stations, which has worked for them. If we look back in 2016, they were saying that they were going to begin construction on the refueling network in January of 2018. But if we look now, they're planning to start construction on their first hydrogen refueling station in Q2 of 2021, with it not being completed until sometime after 2023. So they've delayed building their hydrogen refueling network around 5 years, which has allowed them to put off actually paying for it. But eventually, if they want to start selling trucks, they have to build out hydrogen station, and that is going to cost an insane amount. So I'm glad to hear Russell state clearly that they will be raising more capital because we know they need it. I will say I'm more than a bit skeptical though, because I'm not sure they have the reputation or the ability to raise the kind of money they need to make their refueling station network possible. And this isn't even factoring the cost of their factory under construction in Arizona or with their partnership with GM. To wrap things up, things are not looking good for Nikola. It looks like they might have to drop their Badger pickup line because the GM partnership could fall through, which will make them even less credible as a company. And then they have to take that lack of credibility to the bank and raise even more capital for the hydrogen station and factory rollout. But what do you guys think of their current situation? Let me know in the comment section below, and thanks for watching.